Her name is Kate Vogel, and she's the face and talent behind the character Mia on One Tree Hill. And now she's talking to the CW Source.
You said that there was something magical about their sound, and you couldn't figure out what it was, right? It's Mia. She's the magic, Peyton, and I'm telling you, her spark is getting squashed by this ass of a singer.
Now, a lot of people don't know this, but you are actually a real artist.
I am.
Aside from an actress. Now, how did this all come about? How did this whole One Tree Hill fall on your lap?
Well, what's so cool about it is I'm primarily a musician, and so what's awesome is people who are seeing this for the first time might kind of hear my music for the first time on the show, and what's awesome is, you know, they're really getting exposed to my actual music because Mia plays Kate Vogel's music. Last summer, my manager called me and said, hey, it's a long shot, but there's this casting call for, you know, this part on One Tree Hill. And I kind of laughed at her. I was like, okay, sure. Yeah, I've never done much acting in my life. I was in my high school musical, like, but I'll go for it anyways, you know? And so I walked into the audition room with the creator of the show and the executive producer, some casting people, and was like, what's up, guys? Here's a couple of my songs. Read some lines. And after I finished, Mark Schwann said to me, hey, Kate, I know music is your gig, but you could do this for a living too, you know? I looked at him and I was like, who's this guy? Like, you know, I was like, what? And so I was, you know, totally floored and thrilled, you know, to be in Wilmington shooting my first episode 2-3 weeks later. It was just, like, unbelievable.
Wow, Mia, that's really great. Did you write it?
Oh, it doesn't matter. Jason writes all our songs.
Oh. Well, has the band ever played it?
Really, it's nothing. It, you know... I went into this like, oh my God, am I gonna know what I'm doing, you know? And so I was so excited to get this role because I really felt like I earned it as opposed to, you know, having someone call me and say like, hey, you know, we want you for this part, you know? It was cool to kind of go in there up against a bunch of people and come out, you know, land in the role. It was totally crazy.
Now, you're one of the new faces of this season from One Tree Hill. Mm-hmm. Now, how has the cast taken to you? Did they welcome you with open arms?
Yeah, you know what? It's one thing that totally surprised me in the greatest way about the show was how incredibly friendly and welcoming everybody was. You know, I didn't know what to expect. These people have been working together for the last 4 or 5 years, and so I was thinking, you know, I don't know how it's going to be, but I'm still excited, and people were so great. Like, I made so many good friends, and I had so much fun there, like, you know, in and out of work.
I heard you stole Lucas from Brooke once. Pot meet kettle.
Ass meet face.
Pot, me kettle, ass, me face. I don't think that's gonna work. And it was just such a great time. So that was the best thing about it, was everybody there is so genuine and so down to earth. There was no ego at all.
You really mean that? Absolutely.
Well, believe it or not, but this is Kate's first acting gig. So you're probably wondering, how could this outgoing, bubbly rock star play this shy and quiet Mia?
I'm totally the opposite of shy and quiet, and but it was really cool because when I walked onto the set the first day, you know, Mia's in her hoodie and she's very much in her shell and stuff, and I'd been that girl before. When I was 15, I was totally, you know, not sure of myself and everything, so it was definitely easy for me to tap into that, even though it's totally opposite of my personality.
You work with Kevin Federline.
Yeah.
He's very mean to you on the show, I have to say.
Oh, yeah, his character, man. He's
not very nice.
Mm-mm.
Hi.
You suck! Get off the stage, ho!
You're an idiot.
Don't call me an idiot!
Choke.
How's it working with him?
It was great. You know what? It's so funny because everyone's like, oh my God, Kevin! You know, that's like, it was funny because people kind of ask it like with this voice like, where's the crazy story? What did he do? That's nuts. And it's like, nothing. The guy was a great actor. He was there and he knew his lines and, you know, he was really there to work. But he was also, you know, he's really down to earth too. Like, I wasn't sure what to expect because, I mean, the guy's in the press every 5 minutes, you know, he didn't have any reason to be nice to me, you know. But he was really cool, you know, he was nothing like his character. He was very friendly. And so, yeah, I mean, I give him props. He did a great job.
Later, bitches.
Kate, who recently played a sold-out show at the Knitting Factory in New York City, has plenty on her plate. Between promoting her debut album, Don't Look Away, and shooting One Tree Hill, Kate says she does manage to find time to catch her breath.
You know, the great thing is, a lot of the people that I work with are also my best friends. You know, my band is like my older brothers, and, you know, I've got a lot of friends kind of in the business now. And like I said, on the set, I met so many great people that I'm still really close with and stuff, so that's really cool about it. Definitely, though, it's always great when I do have time for my family and my friends outside of everything. So, you know, it's just a balance. You figure it out.
Between singing and acting, do you have a preference? Clearly, I would say singing because you started out as a singer.
Right, yeah. You know, I'm definitely hugely focused on my record right now and playing live and, you know, just getting it in as many people's hands as possible. But I loved acting. And, you know, because I was playing a musician and playing my music, this was the perfect first acting role. And so, you know, I had such a great time, though. It was such a creative experience, and I didn't know it would be like that. So I'm definitely excited, you know, to do something, some more stuff like that down the road. But right now, I mean, you know, I'm first and foremost for sure a musician. I can't imagine not ever being a songwriter or playing shows. You know, it's just, it's what I do, and I just love it so much. Don't look good. Great work, Mia. Excellent.
That she is. Now, Kate's album, Don't Look Away, is in stores now. And remember, you can always check out this rock star in training every Tuesday at 9 p.m., 8 Central, on One Tree Hill, only on the CW.